So, do you have a Mac that you wish that you could install a newer version of macOS onto? I'm going to take you through the entire process of how to install newer versions of macOS, even on unsupported hardware. Now, the only thing to really consider is that your Mac is powerful enough to run these newer versions of macOS. So, without further ado, let's jump into the video and get started. Cool, so here we are in Big Sur. So if I jump into Safari and I'll do a search just to see the latest version of macOS I can actually install onto this computer. So firstly, I'll click on the Apple menu and click on About This Mac. And I'll just move this over here. And as you can see, this is a mid-2014 iMac. It's running an Intel Core i5 processor and it's pretty limited on RAM. It's got 8 GB of RAM. So the first thing I'll do is do a search for what Mac OS can my Mac run. Here we go. And I'll just click on the first link. It's a pretty good one from Macworld. So shout out to Macworld. This is a great article. It's very, very helpful. And so if I scroll down here, and what I want to look for is mid-2014. Get rid of this advert. And I'll just keep scrolling down. So I'm actually on Big Sur. So this is Big Sur here, and it is compatible with iMacs from 2014 or later. So this is indeed a 2014 iMac. However, if I scroll up here, one version later is Monterey, which I have used in the past quite extensively. This, however, is only compatible with iMacs from 2015 or later. So I couldn't actually install macOS Monterey onto this iMac without using the patcher, which I'm about to show you how to use. So what I'm going to do now is do a search for OpenCore Patcher. Here it is, OpenCore Legacy Patcher. And this is the website. So I'll click on Getting Started. And I want to make sure that the OpenCore Legacy Patcher can actually be installed onto this Mac. So I'll Command Click Supported Models to open a new tab. And let's scroll down here. And because this computer is an iMac, I'll click on the iMac link and that'll take me down to the list. Now I want to find out what the identifier of this Mac is. So to do that, I'll just have to click on System Report. And as you can see, it is an iMac 14,4. So if I scroll down this list here, there we go, the iMac 14,4 from mid-2014. So this is indeed compatible with the OpenCore Legacy Patcher. So I'll close that tab and then go to Download and Build the macOS Installer. So I can close System Information while I'm at it. And then, as you can see, to start off, you'll want to grab the app. So I'll click on this link here to the OpenCore Legacy Patcher Release Apps. And this will take me to their GitHub page for the downloads. And if I scroll down here and I want the latest release, so this is the latest release, which is the OpenCore Patcher.pkg or package. So I'll click that to download. And that's downloading now to my downloads folder. And that has downloaded, so I'll double click on the download from Safari. And I can minimize everything from here. So I'll actually close out of there. I'll actually close out of Safari so when I do my reboot, it won't throw up the error of having shut down prematurely. So I'll quit Safari and let's install the OpenCore Legacy Patcher. So I'll just follow the prompts, go continue, install, enter my password. And that has completed. So I'll close out of the OpenCore Legacy Patcher. It's asking, do I want to move the OpenCore Legacy Patcher installer to the bin? I'll move it to the bin. and then jump into the launchpad, and here is the OpenCore Legacy Patcher. It's cool. So firstly, I want to build and install OpenCore, so I'll click on that, and that's detecting all the hardware in this computer, and then click install to disk. And then I'll select the hard drive that macOS is installed onto. And then also the EFI, which is the boot launcher or boot menu for macOS. So I'll click on that. And that has completed. So now I want to reboot the computer. And when I reboot the computer, as soon as I see the backlight or hear the chimes, what I want to do is press and hold the Alt key to bring up the boot menu so that I can select the OpenCore Legacy Patcher. So I'll click on reboot and then restart, and this is shutting down now. Right, so the computer's booting up and there's the backlight, so I'll hold down Alt and that brings up this menu here. So now if I selected this macOS HD, this will actually boot up Big Sur just normally. However, I want to actually boot through the EFI boot from OpenCore. So I'll select that and then click on the arrow underneath, and then it's showing the options of which macOS versions I have currently. So that's currently Big Sur. So I'll let that boot up now. Cool, and I'll just log in as per normal. And here we are back now in Big Sur. So before I continue, I'm going to open up Safari and I'm going to go back to that Macworld website, which should be in my history. So here is the website that I opened previously. Now, this is just important to note. If I scroll down this page here, this will actually show me what versions of macOS currently still have security patches that are being updated. So as you can see, Sequoia currently has patches that are being applied. And if I scroll down here, Sonoma also is still being updated. Ventura is being updated as well, the most recent patch being in March of 2025, so that's pretty recent. However, Monterey no longer gets security updates. However, for this exercise, I'm going to download Ventura. And this iMac is from mid-2014. So Ventura normally would never be able to run on this iMac because of the hardware incompatibility. However, with the OpenCore Legacy Patcher, I can actually install Ventura. So I'm going to quit out of Safari. And go back to my launch pad and launch OpenCore Patcher. Now, before I download an installer, I'm going to click on this post-install root patch just to make sure that all of the patches have been applied to the system. And as you can see, no patches are required. So I can go back to the main menu. And I'm going to create a macOS installer. So OpenCore actually have legit macOS installers. So I'll click on download a macOS installer. And these are the options that I have. Now I can actually enable show older and beta versions. However, I'm going to deselect the show older beta versions and I'm going to select macOS Ventura. Now this installer is 12.2 gigabytes, so make sure that you have a USB drive handy. It's cool, so with Ventura selected, I'll click download and that'll take a few moments to download. So I'll speed up this bit of the video and I'll rejoin you as soon as this has completed downloading. And that has completed. So now I want to create the macOS installer. So I'll click on yes. and I want to create the macOS Ventura installer. So I'll click on that. And it's saying there's no disks. So I'll get my USB drive. This is a 16 gigabyte USB drive, so it's definitely big enough. So I'll plug that in and then click search for disks again. Cool, so it's picked up the USB drive. So I'll select that and then click yes. And this will now create the macOS installer. So this will take 30 or so minutes. So I'll speed up this bit of the video and rejoin you as soon as this has completed. Cool, so that's completed and it's asking me if I'd like to install OpenCore to the disk, and I've actually already done that. So I'll click no and I can close out of the OpenCore Legacy Patcher. Right, so here is the installer now. So if I go into my launchpad, I actually want to get this icon here. So what I'm going to do is go into my Finder and then go into Applications and then let's find the Ventura installer. Here it is here. So if I select that and then right click and then select get info, and I'll do the same for the USB drive, get info. All I have to do is select the icon and you'll see a blue outline around it, and then command C to copy and then select the USB icon, get that blue ring around it, and then command V to paste, and that is completed. So now I can actually install macOS Ventura onto this computer. So I'll show you that process as well. So what I'll do now is shut down the computer. So make sure everything's shut off, and I'll shut down the computer. So press and hold the Option key to bring up the boot menu, and with the OpenCore EFI boot selected, press Return. Then using my arrow key, select the USB installer and press Return. And we are in luck. So what I need to do next is format the hard drive. So I'll select Disk Utility, then click Continue. Next, I'll select Show All Devices. And here is the macOS hard drive I'll be installing Ventura onto. Now, I've selected the container so I don't wipe the OpenCore EFI bootloader, which is what would happen if I selected the whole device. And to wipe the old macOS version and create a new empty partition, I'll select Erase. And I'll leave the name and format as is and click Erase. So that's completed, so I'll click Done. And now I can close out of Disk Utility. Next, I'll select Install macOS Ventura, then click Continue. And then Continue again. Click Agree to the License Agreement and Agree again. Cool, next I'll select the empty hard drive I just prepared and click Continue, and then let the installer do its installing. And the computer will actually reboot a couple of times. And here we are at the options stage. So I'll select my location and click Continue. The language settings are good, so I'll click Continue. And I don't need to set up accessibility, so I'll click Not Now. And for data and privacy, I'll click Continue. Now, I recommend not to use the migration until OpenCore is fully set up, so I'll click Not Now. I'll set up my Apple ID later, so I'll click Setup Later, then click Skip. And then click Agree to the Terms and Conditions, and Agree again. Next, I'll enter my login account details. And then click Continue. Now I won't enable location services, so I'll click continue and then don't use. Next, I'll manually select the time zone I'm in by clicking the location on the map and then click continue. I'll turn off analytics, then click continue. And I won't set up screen time insights, so I'll click setup later. I'll also disable Siri, then click continue. Now I do prefer the dark theme, so I'll select that. And then click continue. Now the keyboard setup assistant appears here because I am using an aftermarket keyboard, but I know this keyboard works perfectly fine, so I'll click quit. Cool, so here we are in macOS Ventura. So to complete this process, what I need to do is go to my launchpad and launch the OpenCore Patcher again. And then go over to post install root patch and click that. And as you can see, there are available patches for my system, and this will enable macOS Ventura to be fully operational on this computer. So I'll click start root patching. And this shouldn't take too long. Cool, so it's now asking me to reboot the system, so I'll do that now. Click reboot. And again, when it reboots, I'll have to hold down Alt to select the OpenCore EFI bootloader. So I'll just deselect that. Click restart. And there's the backlight, so I'll hold down Alt. And this time, what I want to do is press Control, and as you can see, the selector changes. And so what this means is that if I hold down Control and then press this button here, every time my computer loads, it'll actually load into the OpenCore bootloader, which is exactly what I want. So I'll select that, and that's my USB drive. So with macOS hard drive selected, it'll boot up my computer. And I'll log in now. And there we go, we are all done. So I can now use macOS Ventura and set it up how I like. So thanks for tuning in, and I'll catch you in the next video.